Sri Vishnu Sahasranam, name 375. Vishnu Sahasranam?
Sahasranam.
The name is Udbhava. This name comes in Bhagavad Gita. Mrityu Sarva Harashchaham Udbhavas Cha Bhavishyatam. Krishna says, in the form of death, I take everything away. And he is also the Udbhava, the source of generation of everything in the future. So Udbhava means that which brings into being, the cause. But especially this means the cause of the universe. The universe is sometimes called Bhava. Bhava means that which comes into being. Now, another meaning of Udbhava can be who is above the Bhava. In other words, who is beyond the conditions of this world, who is transcendental, and who cuts the condition of this world, who cuts the bondage of this world. So these are three principal meanings of this name of Vishnu. One who removes the bondage of those who approach him and serve him in pure love. And he sometimes removes the bondage of those who don't even approach him in love.
Sometimes.
In some cases, he gives mukti or cuts the bondage of those even who do not approach him in love.
The
asuras, the demons who approach him to attack him, when he kills them, they also get liberation. Now, just prior to this, one of the names given is Damodara, he who is bound by the rope by Mother Yashoda. So the Sri Vaishnav commentator, he says that particularly, because he likes to give all the names in context with each other, he says that particularly those who meditate on the Leela of Krishna being tied up, then such persons, by his grace, will be untied from material bondage. So he is the source of the universe. He is the source of everything. One of the names, which you just gave as a translation, one of the names of Vishnu that comes here is, just coming up in this same verse, is Karanam, the cause of everything. And Baladev Vidyabhushan is the Gauriya Vaishnav commentator on Vishnu Sahasranama. So he gives many of the meanings of these names in relationship particularly to Krishna and in relationship to Krishna's pastimes in Vrindavan. So he gives the meaning of this name that after the Damodar pastime, after Krishna was bound up by Mother Yashoda, then even in that condition of being tied up, he freed the sons of Kuvera from the bondage of being in the form of trees. So even while he's enacting the pastime of being bound, he unbinds others. Now, the next name is Kshobhana. Another name in Vishnu Sahasranama is a better known name is Akshobhya. Kshobhana means who causes agitation. And Akshobhya means one who is undisturbed and undisturbable. So these appear to be somewhat contradictory names. But of course, all contradictions are resolved in the personality of Krishna. He is the source of everything. Means he is the source of good and bad, of light and darkness, of knowledge and ignorance. He's the ultimate source of everything. Now, he causes agitation. Shobhanam. In Tamil, it doesn't count, no. If it was. Means he makes, just like if you have some liquid is sitting and the sediment has come down to the bottom and you shake it up, that could be called agitation. Or if you make, someone is sitting very peacefully and you come and disturb them and make them angry. Or, people in one country are living very peacefully and then someone goes and tells them, your leaders, they're all bad. And then you agitate them and they make a revolution. So there's physical agitation, mental agitation, political agitation, which is a subset of mental agitation. Now, particularly this name is suitable in relationship to Udbhava, the cause of the universe, inasmuch as Shastra describes that prior to the creation of the universe, everything was in equilibrium. There was no activity. And by the glance of Mahavishnu, Prakriti and Purush started to interact. The Mahatattva, or the primordial matter, became agitated and started to react. And in this way, by his glance, the material energy became agitated and took on various forms. Most commonly accepted theory among not necessarily atheistic, but people who deem themselves scientifically minded, the most accept, well, by far the most accepted theory of the origin of the universe is what is called the Big Bang theory. Big Bang Tattva. But it's more like theory, is that's more like Vada or Parikalpana in Sanskrit. Tattva means it's ascertained. Then it's not a theory. But it's not as, it's a theory. It's not ascertained. So the idea is that all of the matter that we, that is now presently constitutes the universe, was concentrated in an infinitesimal point, and then it exploded, and everything fell into place bit by bit, and here we are today. Well, even if we accept that this theory is correct, although it is highly speculative, although the scientists won't tell you that, unless they uphold a different theory, but they have no explanation of how or why this happened. And those who are atheistic uphold that there's no need to say how, or not to invoke a transcendental or intelligent cause. Yeah, I said atheistic, which is more or less a synonym of asura, but it is a slightly different word. Nastic is the general word. Do you have that word in Tamil? Nastic?
Nastic,
So it's by Krishna's glance. He doesn't actually get involved and stir things up with a spoon, but just by looking, then the material energy becomes agitated and starts to form into the various shapes that we see all around us now. Another meaning is that in this material world, everyone's mind is always disturbed, so the ultimate cause of that disturbance, we can say, is Krishna. Because he's the ultimate cause of everything. Of course, in Bhagavad Gita, he gives us the formula by which we can become peaceful. But for those who don't want to take that information, then their mind will remain perpetually disturbed. So agitation, another meaning, is to cause some motion, just like stirring sugar into your coffee. I hope you don't drink coffee, but if you do, it's an example. So this material world is called Jagat. Gachatiti Jagat. The definition of Jagat is that which moves. So the cause of the movement of the universe and everything within it, that is ultimately Krishna. And he also, apart from causing agitation in the minds of those who don't want to remember him, that is the agitation of kam, krodh, lobh, moha, mada, matsarya, all the inauspicious qualities. He also causes transcendental, blissful agitation in the minds of his devotees, whose minds also become unsteady as their minds, as they think, as the devotees think about Krishna's names, qualities, forms, and pastimes. Then their mind becomes very happily active. Now this world, everything is moving, and it appears to be extremely complex and chaotic. But behind it all is the supreme controller, Krishna. Hare Krishna. So I don't want you to become too disturbed or agitated by having prasadam too late. So we'll finish here, and then you can take prasadam. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.